Hello, welcome to SnowRunner. It's all film video here today. This is going to be just some miscellaneous running around because you can't really do everything with the 8-slot trailer as much as I want to figure out the load order to do that precisely. It just, the math doesn't work out. And so this is going to be one of those. Well, we're just going to have to do some running around relatively inefficiently, as much as I don't like the idea. So first order of business is going to be taking these two metal beams and turning them into metal rolls. Because that's what we need. We're 4 short, so both of these need to be taken. And I'll probably just kind of cut in and out if anything doesn't really happen, because it's just going to be me going the same route twice. And this will probably be put together along with some other miscellaneous stuff like brick moving. I want to show off a little path, just kind of if you have a truck and doesn't really handle that muddy mess really well. Now I have to do this at least once with the semi-trailer just to show it off, but I have used semi-trailers on this little bypass here, so I know it can be done with the standard width ones. I think I may have done it with the light 5-slot semi-trailer. I can't remember. But yeah, if you don't have this big old truck in the mud, in this kind of, these trees can be a problem, admittedly, for the semi-trailers. So, it's not the easiest thing to do, but it is an alternative way just to be aware of. Also, I could be doing this in one trip, but the red sideboard trailer that you tow, it's over near the railway station, so I figured by the time I ran around, got that, brought it here, maybe out in daylight, so I figured just making 2 quick trips would be the better way to use the day. I'll usually do my staging during the night if I'm going to be making a video. Now, of course, this does present a problem in so that the next phase of the contract requires 6 metal beams. So we are kind of in a price, because as it stands, you'd have 2 from the rail station plus 3 from that warehouse where we started. And so you'd only need to bring 1 up here. But since we're doing this, that means I'm going to need to bring 3, so that's going to be an interesting call. I think I have an idea how I'm going to do it. For a minute, I thought there were already 2 metal rolls here, and I was going to go, wait, what? And here we are, back here. One thing I should mention is, you don't have to have trucks from a DLC region. This is just kind of what I have available. On this file, there are plenty of trucks from the base game that could do this running around. You wouldn't necessarily need to resort to something like this that has this powerful an engine. The Boron Brad, the Very Long Arm 3194. And if you can make it work without an all-wheel, without a locking differential, BM-17 Royal would be another good choice for this map, or for doing this particular running around, especially if you're not doing it with a semi-trailer. Of course, if you're going to pull a semi-trailer, then the original Tega 6436 is also a chance, also an option. And then once we deliver this, we'll go and pick up some bricks. Because, let me just see what I have on this trailer. Okay, we don't have any bricks, and we have the first two of the wooden planks. Okay, that's good to know. Actually, I'll just probably go and... No, I need the... Oh, and in case you saw it, the twin steer with its all-wheel drive upgrade would also be a good choice for this map, too. But... while I'm doing that, we'll go get the bricks from here. Those two wooden planks, in case people aren't familiar with the map, came from right here. And I've been trying to basically just make it so you don't have to go out of your way with this guy. So, I grabbed these bricks and then brought them down here. I grabbed the wooden planks, and then I grabbed a set of bricks from here. Now, I haven't gone up here, but there are some metal beams here. So you could argue that grabbing these and then bringing them down here would be a way to get the two other metal beams you need. So you only have to bring one of them across the map. I'm basically just trying with this guy to set up a situation where you're not running all of crisscrossing the map all over the place to get materials. Because you burn a lot of fuel doing that and maneuvering through the mud, so I'm trying to keep this as to efficient routes and paths as possible. It's not always possible. You are going to end up doing some running around like what I'm doing right here. It's kind of unavoidable with this contract. But I'm trying to kind of show and demonstrate a relatively efficient way to do it. This area, it is kind of deepish mud. It's just not as bad as this little area. I don't know if it's that little rise in the middle that makes this path so bad, and that path doesn't have it, but it's slightly better, so you can also use that. Now that we have the rolls, this isn't the most efficient thing to do, but I have a little extra money, so I'm just going to do this. But we're actually going to buy a trailer here, even though I technically already have the trailer and I'm going to buy it on the map already. It's just going to make life a little easier and faster. And so, we're just going to buy... Of course, it's going to be down here. We're just going to buy that. And that way we can load up all four metal rollers and take them to the mine in one trip. It's just going to make things a little easier. The beeping you're hearing is because... Let me see if I can... Okay, there. The beeping is just there because the truck was in reverse, so if you have it, make sure to go forward if the beeping bothers you while you're doing this. Also, I wish I didn't have to exit crane mode every time I wanted to put something on that dock to pick up with the crane. It's kind of one of those nice quality of life things I'd love to see come to SnowRunner. For people who are doing hard mode or roleplay and don't want to auto-load stuff. In hard mode, it costs $150 per unit of cargo. Sometimes I pay it because it's worth it, or I don't have a crane nearby and it's like one or two pieces of cargo. But when you're moving cargo like these metal rolls, you can rack up a fortune real fast. So, yeah, it pays to have a crane. Let's just put it that way. Now that our cargo's packed, we can go and deliver it. I just noticed what my fuel was. I was actually planning on, after I dropped these off, there are some brick houses up here where you can get additional bricks, and I was going to go grab those. And there's at least one in here that you can grab, but I just realized I don't think I have the fuel for that. So I'm going to either have to park this at the mine and bring fuel up here, or I'm going to have to drive it back to the warehouse where I have the Kodiak C-70 configured as a fuel truck. that is one thing I've noticed. Using the V8 on this truck will burn fuel at a higher rate than you're expecting. So it really does, to some extent, put it in the class of what you expect from special class engines in terms of fuel consumption. If you want modern truck engine fuel consumption and you're doing relatively small loads like this, don't tip it. The stock V6 is probably where it has more manageable fuel consumption compared to what you'd expect out of a modern truck engine, like on the Boring Rat or the V17 Corvette, for example. Honestly, what I could do is I could just run over there. There's all the middle rows. I'll just drop this trailer here, and I can bring the Athion here, and I'll pick up this trailer and go grab those turrets and bring them back here. That's probably the best way to do this, so we're gonna go get fuel, grab those two other brakes on our way back up with this truck. And that should put us at 8 of 10 bricks. I'll just have to figure out what is the place I'm going to grab the last few bricks. Bro, what happened while you were gone? I didn't make it to the fuel truck. Made it about right here and ran out of fuel, and then had to drive the fuel truck, refuel this, and then took it down and drained most of its fuel into this, and now it's sitting out in the garage to drain a little more before I send it to another region to get fuel. So then I drove the Mack back up here to get these, and then we'll deliver them, and then come and get these. We'll go from there. Got those. Next stop, the mine. the sense part can be a little tricky depending on the truck. But one way to minimize your chance of tipping is to turn out with the brake and then turn in. That way you're always keeping your truck facing up or downhill to minimize the risk of tipping. It's one way to handle this whole area. Although I don't think you have to worry about tipping as much with this truck. He says, right as he's cruising, it's going to go over. Great timing. And we come to our second group of houses. And now, for the sake of convenience, we will go down and get the final two bricks and see if I can put off making the cabins to the end of this or if I need to do the cabins in order to advance this to the next part. Also, we're gonna pull this thing back right side of Pontius Fields. I don't know what happened here, but there. Personally, wouldn't use this with a semi-trailer. I think it's a little too tight, but if you don't mind running cargo up two slots at a time, you could potentially get some stuff from down here. Right here at the bottom, we have another set of bricks, so let's pick those up. Back up. One thing's for sure, you need plenty of power to do this. This is not for heavy load or a relatively weak truck. It's between the branches and the grades and these rocks. You're gonna need some power to pull this off. Okay, thanks for watching.